Psychiatry Industry of Death, written by a truth soldier. Psychiatry, the hidden agenda, is social control to achieve their new world order plans. Psychiatry is politics. It is the application of force against those who do not want to be forced. In October 1945, at the United States Department of the Interior in Washington, D.C., co-founder of the World Federation for Mental Health, G. Brock Chisholm said, "To achieve world government, it is necessary to remove from the minds of men their individualism, loyalty to family traditions, national patriotism, and religious dogmas." In a 1950 conference on mental health for children and youth at the White House, it was planned that there would be a total reorientation of the public school system, so that it would now include the involuntary psychological testing, labeling, and putting children on mind-altering, very addictive and very harmful drugs. This is part of their deliberately dumbing down of Americans' plan. In 1965, to implement their master plan, American psychiatrists convinced Congress that mental illness was a national threat that only they with a mass increase in funding could solve. Therefore, the National Mental Health Act, H.R. 4512, was passed to start the federal funding of psychiatric testing and administering of drugs on the vulnerable in our society, our children and future generation. It only takes a 5-minute interview with a psychiatrist to label a child and force the child onto drugs. The parents have no control or say in this, and the parents can also be tested and forced on drugs. In 1984, there were 4.4 million children diagnosed with ADHD. There is no diagnostic test for ADHD. Therefore, there is no way to validate the diagnosis. ADHD is really just children bored to death in school. Schools today do not encourage children to develop their own individual thinking. The school curriculum today is designed to deliberately dumb down society. Children are being programmed to do no critical thinking of their own. They are being programmed to accept everything the system tells them and to fit in like everyone else. Individuality is not accepted. No free thinking allowed. Any child that shows superior thinking is deliberately kept down or is put on drugs or worse. Or their education gets sabotaged so that they cannot get any education. All through society, outstanding intellectuals are being destroyed. This is also part of the New World Order plans. They are creating a slave puppet society. Note, many psychiatry patients are those that have been altered due to the use of over-the-counter drugs, street drugs, alcohol, or even prescription drugs. We must aim to make it permeate every educational activity in our material life, public life, politics, and industry. Should all of them be in our sphere of influence? We have made a useful attack upon a number of professions. The two easiest naturally are the teaching industry and the church. The most difficult are law and medicine. And let's not forget the secret MKUltra mind experiments program. Experiments were done to the homeless and 50,000 unwanted orphans in Montreal and the United States during the 50s and early 60s. This is how they created the street drug LSD and possibly many other street drugs. It has always been suspected that the CIA is the institution that controls the street drug industry, and that they use the proceeds to run their covert operations. Psychiatrists' master plan to infiltrate all sections of society has been realized. We don't have an epidemic of mental illness. We have an epidemic of psychiatry. You need to spread the truth. Join the truth revolution by getting informed and then inform others. Psychiatrists have openly admitted that they cure nothing and that they have no scientific experiments or means to diagnose or prove any diagnosis. All psychiatrists do is put harmful labels on people. These labels are usually believed by the patients. The labels do a lot of harm. And vulnerable and easily influenced simple people end up believing these labels and eventually end up acting the way they are labeled. It's called the power of suggestion or hypnosis. Maybe some psychiatrists do not realize that they are just in the business of administering drugs and undermining free society to fulfill the New World Order agenda. Remember, truth equals mental health. Lies and deceptions equal mental illness. If you fill your mind with lies and deceptions, then you will be mentally ill. Please note that CCHR had no participation in the writing of this article. Not all information or comments in this article came from CCHR. Any information gathered from the CCHR movie is being supplied here for public educational purposes only. CCHR maintains all copyright to the original information in the Psychiatry and Industry of Death movie. But I believe that this information should be freely copied and distributed by anyone. As it is, the public needs this information that has to do with and is vital to the public good. Man's wars, his revolutions, his suffering, all stem from his lack of data on the mind and man. With psychiatric dominance of this field, we have had a century of untold suffering and violence. Some of this information has been compiled from the Citizens Commission on Human Rights International movie, Psychiatry and Industry of Death. To find out how you can become a part of the Citizens Commission on Human Rights or to obtain further materials, call 1-800-869-2247 or visit www.cchr.org. Please watch this movie on Google Video website. Psychiatry Instrument of Death. Please read by other Realtid article entitled Who is Delusional Now? At donnyltowsey.wordpress.com. Psychiatry Industry of Death.